Do you have a better idea?
Yes, I do.
Since you guys were such big fans of my last video, I thought I'd go ahead and keep spouting my views on historical and present politics and history, backed up by facts, sourced down below of course, which are always completely uncontroversial. So in this video, I'm covering the historical anarcho-syndicalist state, or lack thereof, the C.N.T F.A.I, or, and sorry in advance for this pronunciation, the Confederación Nacional del Trabajo, Federación Anarquista Ibérica, aka Revolutionary Catalonia, in this quick summary. Just as a disclaimer, I'm going to be doing a lot more of these videos in the future, so if you don't like that, then feel free to leave. And if you're fine with that, then awesome! Let's get started on a really interesting group, in my opinion.
Please, good people, I am in haste. Who lives in that castle?
No one lives there.
Then who is your lord?
We don't have a lord.
What? I told you, we're an anarcho-syndicalist commune. We take it in turns to act as a sort of executive officer for the week.
Yes.
But all the decisions of that officer have to be ratified at a special bi-weekly meeting.
Yes, I see.
By a simple majority in the case of purely internal affairs.
Be quiet.
But by a two-thirds majority in the case of more...
Be quiet. I order you to be quiet.
The C.N.T F.A.I was made up of anarcho-syndicalists, hoping to establish anarcho-communism. Now, what exactly are those two ideologies? Well, if I would have gotten to my Meet the Lib Left video, then you would know by now, so sorry about that. But let's go ahead and try to explain just what is anarcho-communism and anarcho-syndicalism. Both of these ideologies were heavily inspired by the works of Kropotkin, aka Breadboy, and advocate for some form of a dismantling of the state due to perceived unjust hierarchies, and advocated that the only fair ruling of people is directly from the people, in the forms of workers' councils and direct democracy, which need to be implemented in order to pass legislation. Anarcho-syndicalism is centered on the idea that power corrupts, and that any hierarchy that cannot be ethically justified must be dismantled. The main difference between anarcho-communism and anarcho-syndicalism is that anarcho-communism is an anarchist vision for a post-capitalist society, while anarcho-syndicalism is an anarchist strategy to achieve such a society. There tends to be a major overlap between the two ideologies, with anarcho-syndicalism generally being seen as the method to achieve anarcho-communism, with not all of these groups definitively agreeing upon that, but in practice that's the best definition I can give. Summed up, it's a system used through direct democracy and workers' councils to break down perceived unjust hierarchies, such as monarchies, theocracies, capitalism, really any system in which people are ranked above each other, according to status or authority that cannot be ethically seen as justified to the people in that society, which has a focus on the communal with a redistribution of the wealth to all people, given that all are seen as equal and should be treated as such. Now, of course, in practice, this could vary, but this is the view and the ideology of both anarcho-syndicalists and the C.N.T F.A.I. In the early 20th century, socialism and anarchism were on the rise in Spain, in particular the heavily industrialized region of Catalonia. Now, during the Bourbon Restoration, carried out by the traditionalist and monarchist groups, the C.N.T was established as an alternative to the growing socialist and Marxist movement, the UGT, in 1910, who grew in response to the monarchists regaining power. The C.N.T had a split within the group between moderates and radicals, with the radicals believing the establishment of the C.N.T had become too bureaucratic, which, mind you, for an anarchist group means having any involvement in pre-established governments and organizations, which led to the establishment of the F.A.I. in 1927. This was during the rule of the Miguel Primo de Rivera dictatorship, which was inspired and very similar to the Italian Mussolini coup. Both were in parliamentary monarchies that they overthrew to create their illiberal democracy, with the consent of their kings, with both of them being appointed prime minister by said kings. But in reality, they were just dictators. Rivera was actually the one who originally appointed Francisco Franco as a general in the army. But unlike Mussolini, Rivera wasn't able to hold on to his power after the economic devastation that was the Great Depression. After the fall of the Rivera dictatorship, the monarchy soon followed, with the abdication of the King Alfonso XIII following the establishment of a new Second Spanish Republic. The C.N.T and F.A.I remained underground and illegal, slowly gaining popularity and occasionally aligning for general strikes with the UGT and clashing with the fascist phalangists and other traditionalist groups during these strikes. The underground trade union, C.N.T, merged into an alliance with the UGT, other leftist groups, and even some liberal capitalist groups, forming the Popular Front, to contest the right-wing government in power. And in the February 1936 election, the Popular Front coalition swept the election, crushing the National Front, gaining a combined total of 122 seats, giving them a clear majority in government. Following this election, after periods of clandestine operations, followed by other shorter periods of legalization, the CNT was finally legalized. Now, while the Nationalists were revolting against the Second Spanish Republic due to the recent electoral success of the Popular Front, their National Front of Falangists, Carlists, Monarchists, and Traditionalists revolted against the government due to their hatred of feared progress by this new Popular Front government in the Second Spanish Republic, and longed for a return to the Rivera days. During the same time, the anarchists revolted in their strongholds, most notably in Catalonia, gaining control of regions and establishing their anarcho-syndicalist state, consolidating power and aligning the C.N.T. F.A.I. into one group, with the more radical F.A.I. slowly gaining more control over the alliance as time went on. The C.N.T. F.A.I. were still aligned with the Popular Front in a loose coalition against the Nationalists, and both are vehemently anti-fascist. But occasional clashes between the Popular Front and their militias, which were built more for street fighting than open war, led to constant infighting throughout the Civil War between the Popular Front and the anarchists. Catalonia, under the control of this anarcho-syndicalist group, implemented many economic changes, collectivizing industries into worker councils and trade unions. Everything from the factories to movie theaters were nationalized and under the direct control of the people. George Orwell described it when he first arrived in Barcelona as, "The first time I had ever been in a town where the working class was in the saddle. Every shop and cafe had an inscription saying they had been collectivized. Waiters and shopwalkers looked at you in the face and treated you as an equal." Thousands of these industries were previously owned by the upper classes and seized by the people. All firms with more than 100 workers were collectivized, and those with 100 or less could be collectivized if a majority of the workers agreed upon it. These anarchic communes quite often produced more than before the collectivization and worked on entirely libertarian principles. Decisions were made through councils of ordinary citizens without any sort of bureaucracy. Major women's liberation movements happened within revolutionary Catalonia, mainly led by the Mujeres Libres, an anarchist women's organization aiming for the empowerment of working-class women in the highly rigid and sexist society of this historical Spain. These groups organized activities ranging from education programs and technical classes to childcare. While many in the CNT FAI were fine with this movement and actively supported it, there were also many of those greatly opposed to this anarcho-feminist movement, though it should be noted they did not consider themselves anarcho-feminists. During the war, some women even fought at the front, with even more women's battalions behind the lines. Revolutionary Catalonia would eventually be slowly absorbed into the Popular Front, until the eventual capitulation of the Popular Front in 1939 to the Nationalists. All groups in the Spanish Civil War committed some form of terror of some kind, and just because I am a leftist doesn't mean I won't try to be impartial about the CNT-FAI, and give a fair analysis of them during the Spanish Civil War. It's been estimated that 8,352 out of a total of 38,000 victims of the Red Terror were committed by Revolutionary Catalonia. Compare this to the White Terror committed by the Nationalists, who had anywhere from 160,000 to 200,000 victims. While both committed atrocities, the Francoists killed more than double the civilians and innocents than both the Anarchists and Popular Front combined. However, since the Catholic Church heavily supported the Nationalist cause, the Catholic Church came under attack throughout the region. Church buildings are burned or taken over by the CNT or by supporters of the Popular Front. Now, while these crimes of course need to be remembered and are important, they pale in comparison to the crimes of the Nationalists, with their far higher death toll, which has even been seen according to some historians as genocide, especially against Freemasons, those who weren't Catholic, and the extreme repression of Catalans and Basque people. But this isn't a video on the Nationalist war crimes, because if that was the case, we'd be here all day. Let's wrap this up by stating that while the CNT-FAI committed crimes like all other groups in the Spanish Civil War, and those shouldn't be excused or forgotten, they were far less in comparison to those of the other groups in the war, especially that of the Nationalists. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, then awesome. Please feel free to leave a like and subscribe. And go ahead and let me know what you thought about the C.N.T F.A.I. And if you didn't like this video and you have a legitimate criticism, then please let me know down below. And no, if you are a self-admitted fascist, then that's not a legitimate criticism. Please feel free to fuck off my channel and reevaluate your life. Anyways, new videos soon. Love you guys. Bye!